I don't know what I'm going to say today. Okay. It's been rainy for the past 2 weeks, and on the first nice day, I get to spend it in my basement. Yep. Wow, this is a disaster. It's probably been like 15 minutes and I've said nothing. Hi everyone, welcome back to What's Sewing On. I am making myself a fall purse today. This project has been in the works for quite some time. If you've seen any of my reveals before, if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know there is one purse that I wear almost every day in the spring, fall, summer, not in that order. This one. I love this purse, and I don't know if it's because it's rattan or if it's round. I just really like it, and I've already had to fix this one twice, so I kind of want to make myself my own. It's not going to be rattan. I'm actually going to be sewing it out of wool, but I've been planning this project for quite some time now, so today is the day I'm finally doing it. So I got this wool material probably over a year and a half ago. I've actually used it before for my tailor's ham. I've used it for my sewing pincushion, but I originally bought it for this purse, so I'm finally using this fabric for its intended purpose. This isn't really a tutorial because I think tutorials, you actually have to know what you're doing to show people how to do it, but I'm just going to kind of wing it. I feel like it's pretty easy, straightforward, basically just round and making it like a smush sphere. I don't know if there's another word for that. I'm gonna be doing a zipper enclosure, but the way I think I'm gonna do the zipper, I feel like it's probably going to be pretty easy. Why do I always do that to myself? The one thing I am going to be adding, and I've already done this, this video was actually supposed to come out last week, but I realized super quickly last weekend that embroidery is hard. I don't even want to tell how many hours I've already spent on this purse just to do the embroidery. I haven't even started construction of it. I wanted to do the embroidery first and then just show the construction of the purse, and it took me so long. I embroidered for the whole weekend last weekend, and then I had to keep doing it after work all this week. I finally finished it last night. I'm not an embroiderer. I've only done it once before, and that was for my Gobbla Gobbla Turkey apron that I made almost a year ago. So I really don't know how, and I didn't really look up how to do stitches. I know basic satin stitch and that sort of thing. So I was trying to make it really basic, but I guess I didn't, do that. I wanted to make my own embroidery pattern. I was thinking about buying one online to follow along, but I actually have a lot of floss already that I've been thrifting throughout the year for no particular reason at all, because I never really thought I was going to be embroidering that much. But whenever I see it and it's cheap enough, why not? So for the pattern, I was just thinking of fall things. So first things that come to mind are changing leaves, acorns, pumpkins, mushrooms. I kind of wanted to put all that together, so I just drew out a really rough outline of what I wanted it to look like, and I actually really liked my first draft, so I ended up just using that. So I just sketched this out on some pattern paper with a pencil, and then I went over it in marker again just so I can see through it a little bit. The fabric I'm using is a dark gray, so I know that I wouldn't really be able to use this. I ended up ordering some stabilizer. I believe it's called Sulky. I have no idea where I ended up putting the roll, so I'm gonna have to find that. But it's water-soluble stabilizer. I don't know if I picked the perfect one for it. Again, I didn't really look into it that much. I just needed something that was going to stabilize it a little bit. And I was basically just using it so I could have a pattern to follow on. And it ended up working pretty well. My embroidery floss is not organized. I have it all in a tin, and it's just all in there. But recently I did get a bunch all in a bag. These were 50 cents each. There's quite a bit there, and there's a lot of fall colors. Basically what I did, I just had my color expert help me and pick through all the colors I actually wanted. And I settled on some really basic colors. I did a nice dark green, a bit of a lighter green, a rust color, a maroon color. There's a bit of a pop of orange for the pumpkins, but again, it's not the brightest orange I could find. I tried to get one a little bit more muted, and then obviously red and white for the mushrooms. I'm just kidding, I'll actually show you how I did some of it. Thank you.
half of the world are nuts. Half of the world live in trees, the other half in huts. 50% keep laughing, 50% just cry. Half are rich, half are poor, and here's the reason why. Now someone made a wedding ring for no good reason at all. Someone made the bee to sting for no good reason at all. Someone with a wrinkled brow gave the world the marriage vow. Look how many suffer now for no good reason at all. The styles keep changing every year for no good reason at all.
Did you do that? Is this you? Boop. You big suck. You. Tired boy. Now that I have the embroidery out of the way, actually, before I move on, I would like to know from embroiderers, if there is any watching, 39 hours to do this kind of a pattern, that's a lot, right? Like, I know I'm a beginner, it's literally only my second time doing it, but that's a lot. Like, am I just really slow? I thought I was going to be able to finish that in like 3 nights kind of thing. I started on a Thursday, I did a little bit on Friday night. I did almost 12 hours on the Saturday. I did another 10 hours on the following Sunday. Yeah, I just sat in front of the TV for a whole weekend. It was glorious, but also really sad because I thought I was going to be able to embroider and do the purse all in one weekend. False. But anyways, embroidery is done. Now I'm going to put the purse together, which I am super nervous for. I was more nervous about this construction of the purse than actually the embroidery. So I'm hoping that I swapped that, or maybe both are just gonna be really hard. I have no idea. I'm gonna go cut out the pattern pieces. I will show you what I do as I do it. And hopefully I will have a purse at the end of this video. I have all my pieces cut out. I put some interfacing on the one with the embroidery. So I have 4 of these. This is for the zipper. I'll show you what I'm planning on doing with that in a second. And then I have kind of the backing that goes all around. This is 32.5 inches by 5. These 2 are 5 inches by 2 each. And then this is 2.5 by 10.5. So the zipper, I just decided to go with this zipper. I never have zippers, but I got this for $5.99. It's just a bag full of them. Black is the only one that's similar. There's this like silver gray color, but I don't really like it with it. So I think this will be fine. It is a little bit small, but my hand can get in there. So that's all I care about. For the lining, I was going to actually just use lining, but then in my pile of shame, yes, that is literally all of my scraps for every project I've ever done. I don't get rid of anything, which I should. I had some of this other wool fabric. I used it for my skirt, my brown skirt. So I had like enough for the pieces that I needed. So I kind of want to just use this. So I cut it out. I was planning on doing a lining that was like, you put it, insert it inside, but honestly, I cannot wrap my head around
how to flip the fabric so it's inside with the zipper. I just can't think of what to do. So I think what I'm going to do is just sew all these pieces together. And then yes, you're going to see the, you know, stitching on the inside, but it's the inside of the purse. It's my purse. I don't really care that much. Maybe I'll figure out a way to do it for the next time I make this, but for now, I'm just not going to worry about it. I think I'm just going to stitch all these together. I'm going to serge all the pieces, and then I'm going to start with the zipper first because I hate zippers. I have my zipper in, it's pressed. I'm just going to go and do a top stitch just over here and here just to kind of connect it together and make sure that it doesn't move. Then I have my two tabs here already made. So these are the 5x2, and then I've just folded them in so the seam allowance is on the inside. I did stitches down here, and I also ended up doing a stitch right down the middle just to make sure that nothing kind of gets caught and it doesn't rub the fabric too much. So once these are folded together, I'm going to put them on either end of the zipper so they pop up like this. I'm going to get as close as I can to the head of the zipper, and I'm going to get as close as I can to that stopper, and I'll probably leave about a half an inch seam allowance in there, and it'll just pop out like this. I have to make kind of the insert that this sits into. What I'm going to do, I'm going to fold these in half, mark where the half is on each of them. 8.5 inches long, 1 inch wide. Need a new ruler. My lines are starting to be gone. So I need 8.5. And then I measured 1/2 inch out from both of the lines because here I'm going to be making a triangle coming out so that they can fold under and there won't be any raw edges. So I've marked it out for both. I'm going to do it separately because I need a new rotary blade. This one's getting pretty dull and I can't remember where I put the last one that I bought. So it's not really going through my thread. So remember to buy some more blades. And I measured out 1 inch here because this is how much I kind of need to make sure it folds under. So my snip lines that are going to be in the triangle are going to end at both of those. So I'm just going to do that with scissors so I'm more accurate. So once I cut it open, I just pressed the edges underneath. And then for the back one, I pressed it upwards. And then I've sandwiched it together so the lining is going to be attached. I'm just going to go and do a top stitch all around the outside. I did cut mine a little bit too big on both sides, but honestly, once these are flipped up, I don't think you're going to really see it that much anyways. So note for next time to make it a little bit smaller. So now all my pieces are done. I just have to put them together now. I ended up putting interfacing in the back, and then I put it on the sides of this piece too. It's just floating in there because I didn't want to see the stitch lines, and then it's pretty bulky. I got this for like $1, and I guess it's an ironing board cover. Didn't realize that until I opened it up, but I'm using it as that just so it has a little bit more structure. I wanted to make sure that there was enough room for seam allowance and this bulky wouldn't get in there, so I'm hoping this will be okay. It kind of feels quilted, and you know, if all else fails, these can just be like pot holders. What I'm going to do, because I want to make sure that this is completely centered, I'm going to make sure it's straight. So I want it about like that. And then just mark the corner, I mean the edges. And then do the same thing for this piece. So fold it in half, make sure the zipper's in the middle. So now I know whenever I'm pinning it to match up the chalk marks. And then I'm going to go around and pin it first and see how much seam allowance I have left. And then I think I'll unpin it, and then I'll come and actually sew these parts together. So I'll pin it when it's already in the round. I just want to make sure it's an accurate size before I actually do any stitches. So I'm going to go do that now. I'll test it out. Oh my gosh. And then sew in the round, which I'm really nervous about. I just know I'm gonna be so hard on myself right now. I don't want to say I don't like it, because I do like it. I am happy with it. It's not perfect, but like, what of mine is ever perfect? There's just something about it that I'm not 100% in love with, and I can't figure out why. I know there's one specific leaf that I hate, and it really annoys me every time I look at it, but I don't think it's the whole leaf that's throwing me off. Is it the colors, maybe? Because this is so poppy, everything else kind of blends in. I do like it, what is it? I don't know what it is. I don't know. I do really like it, okay. I think it's super cute. I really like it. But there's always a but with me. I am so critical on myself. I don't know what it is. I think it's just because I'm too close to it. I have been working on it for so many hours. I've been staring at it for so long that I think I just need a break from it, that I can't really appreciate it yet, because I'm still just thinking that I spent 49 hours making this. That is longer than my day job. Actually, while we're getting into that, So where I live, $14 an hour is our minimum wage. So if I did 14, because I can't do math, $686. If I was paying myself minimum wage where I live, $686, not even including materials. That's just in time. I know that, you know, 49 hours for somebody who actually does embroidery, it probably wouldn't take them this long. I know that was just me. I had trouble with matching. I ran into a lot of problems with the knots. I'm just not a professional embroiderer by any means, so I'm sure it could go a lot faster, but 49 hours, this is a lot of time. This leaf was my very first leaf, and I really wish I would have started with a different leaf than the biggest one that's kind of not the main focus, but it's, you know, right in the middle. I should have started maybe this one, or maybe even this small one here. I tried to do something, and obviously I switched my methods later on, and I ended up really liking my top one up here and my bottom one down here. The other leaves, I kind of did a mix and a match. So my very first ones I did, I went in with the tan and the red one, and I just did a satin stitch all the way around, and I did like the look of it, but I didn't love it. And then I kind of played around over on this one. I kind of did this V sort of thing to get kind of a leaf-like shape, and I ended up loving it so much that I ended up doing all the other ones just like that. And I like those ones way better than I like the satin stitch. I don't know, I guess just the more I played around with it and I did them, the better it started looking. So I guess maybe I should have done a mock-up first, but mock-up with embroidery just does not sound great. But it's not like it's awful. It's just, I just really like, you know, the other ones a little bit better. I love my acorns. I think they're so adorable. I liked using the little French knot for them. They have like
just little fuzzies. I don't know. I really like that part about it. The pumpkins I think are super cute. I love my little mushrooms. They're adorable. Again, they're a really bright color compared to the rest of it. So I know like they are supposed to be the focus. That is supposed to be the pop. So it's really not that bad of a thing. I don't think that really bugs me. I just, again, I get so focused on color because I don't see it properly that I don't know in my mind if this looks cohesive to a person who can see color properly. I hope that makes sense. It spaced out really nicely around it. I think I did a pretty good job with that. The construction of the purse came together fairly easily. It still took me a couple hours to do it, and I think I could do a better job next time around. But for my first time, I really like it. I did go too big on the outside. I kind of did that weld sort of pocket look, and I love the look of it. I'm glad I did that. But again, I went a little bit too big. When the tabs are open, you don't really notice it that much, so it's fine. And my other issue I had was when I put it in the round, and this is the thing I was scared about the most. Maybe I didn't notch it properly. I went in first and I did a long base stitch all the way around, and then I kind of pulled it all out so it wouldn't be, because sometimes it was bulky just a little bit. And then after that, I went a quarter inch lower and then I just did a regular stitch, but you're still getting some of that kind of bulk and it kind of scrunches a little bit. I'm not sure if I can do anything about that. You'll have to let me know in the comments. I did go in and iron, which was such a hard thing to do. I ended up, you know, having it flipped inside out and I went it all around the edges. That wasn't really doing anything. So then I ended up just using my iron on my hand like this and going around. It helped a bit. It didn't completely obviously take out all of the little kind of scrunches, but it helped. I wouldn't recommend doing that. The only reason I did do it is because my interfacing inside is literally ironing board material. So I assumed I was going to be okay, and I was, but I would not recommend doing that with any other type of fabric. And the last thing, the strap. This isn't the strap that I want to use. I actually haven't found the strap I want to use. This is just leather shoestring that I had. And in my head, I was like, oh, that might look pretty cute with it. And it's not like it looks awful, but it's very flimsy and it's just not the look that I want. So I think what I'm going to do, I was actually planning on maybe trying to braid it or something like that, but no. I'm just going to look at the thrift store whenever I go. Maybe I'll find a strap on a different purse that I like better. And I think I'll swap it out for that once I find it. But for now, this one works. It's long enough that I can do crossbody, or I can just do over the shoulder, or I can just carry it like this, like a handbag. It works for now, but this is definitely not the final look I'm going for. I already want to make one for winter, so I think I'm probably just gonna start embroidering it now so I don't take up as much time, and I can just do a little bit over time instead of trying to cram it all into one weekend, because that was probably my biggest mistake. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like, and I hope you subscribe. I will see everybody on Tuesday or Wednesday for my next video. Should do a what's in my bag. Ugh, wow. Okay, I have 15 minutes before I have to go back to work. Material, no, none of that is good. I have to get a mini travel lint roller just to wear in this purse. A minute, ugh. Like 27 minutes of me just 38 minutes. Oh, amazing. I feel like that was pretty good. I think I got everything I wanted to say out. Do I need to just start completely again, or am I gonna put that whole smorgasbord of hate in there? Hi everyone, welcome back to— yeah, that's right. Okay. Whew. Probably don't look at me like that. This picks up every hair that I shed. It has now rained for 3 days straight. So I'm going to be taking reveal shots of this thing probably in the rain, because the vision I had for it was fall leaves, but now they're all damp, soggy fall leaves. Ew. I don't know. I don't know, Farley. Just don't know.